going about doing this movie was, you know, thinking that if we had done this thing in a controlled set, you would have never saw the performance. It was truly birthed in pain. Oh. And it immediately threw me on my face. I've become him. And it was a big part of that. I don't want people to see me. I want them to see Jesus. I was scourged, accidentally hit with, during carrying of the cross, my shoulder was dislocated. Up on the cross, I had, you know, I weighed 210 pounds. In the filming, I was about 168. I was so sick, I kept throwing up, had my both lungs filled with fluid, pneumonia. After the movie was over, many people don't know, and I don't talk about it too much, but I have to have heart surgery. I was struck by lightning on the last shot of the day. At that moment, it was, I'm ready to go home. So you can take me here, there's no problem. But I knew if I died making this movie, I knew that people would, so many people would be saved. Right now we're going through a time period where things are being stripped from us, and they will, and it's good, because you understand, you don't need all the things that we've been given. They aren't your given right. They're going to be stripped. We're living in this time right now where the world is going to be fasting, and it's going to get hard before it gets better. But God, the people need to see God in you, and the devil is going to sift you out. He's going to look right now. Where are you weak? I can get this guy $1 million and he'll turn. 10 million for this guy, 50 over here. They'll all turn. They'll all say, well, choice, my freedom to choose. Every generation of Americans needs to know that freedom exists not to do what you like, but having the right to do what you ought. If you want to look at it this way, the problem I see right now is the fact that many, many Christians have immersed themselves in paganism. They want to be cool to their Christian or pagan friends by being a little pagan so they can be cool. There's nothing cool in this. The only thing lacking in you is that you don't want to be holy. Well, here's what will happen. We'll all come to task one day, and you either get a chance to lay it down for Jesus or you'll get to deny him. But it will come in our generation this way. There are many things that you see on the horizon right now where you're going to have to make a choice. You will have to make a choice. I hear people all the time in Hollywood, they say, you know what? My agent just died. And he was so embarrassed by his death, he didn't want anybody coming in because it was very hard for those people to watch. Well, guess what? Suck it up. We need Christians to go look death in the face and understand the next point, to encourage these people to understand that eternity awaits them. We're all going to die, the first death. Hopefully not the second. God never sends a man to hell. People choose this place.
Yeah.
Our democracy cannot be sustained without a shared commitment to certain moral truths about the human person and the human community. The basic question before a democratic society is this: how ought we to live together? And in seeking an answer to this question, can society exclude moral truth and moral reasoning? Set yourselves apart from this corrupt generation, my brothers and sisters. You weren't made to fit in. You were born to stand out. Earlier I said, God never sends a man into hell. People choose this place. Your choice. God made you and loves you. There's never been another like you. He asked you and you came. Today, you came. You had the courage to come. And there was plenty parts of the world that pulled you from today from even coming, but you came. Don't you know how much God will remember this? Do you think he is a God that's just sitting there waiting to toss you off? You are perfect. There is no one else like you. And without you, he would cry. So he's coming to you now, right now, in this moment. All he has to hear from you is yes. Yes, you've accepted Jesus, some of you. Keep accepting him.